Hello everyone. Today I am with my new video on microscopy and I am Dr. Taruna, Associate Professor in Microbiology at SP Medical College, Bikaner. The morphological study of bacteria and other microorganisms requires the use of microscope. Why we require microscope? For morphological study of bacteria and for other microorganisms. Microscopy has come a long way since Leeuwenhoek first observed bacteria over 300 years ago. So microscope was first invented by Antony von Leeuwenhoek. The various types of microscopy are bright field or light microscopy, which you people are using in your day-to-day practice or in your laboratory work. Then there is dark field or dark ground microscopy. Third one is phase contrast microscopy, then fluorescence microscopy and electron microscopy, which we use for diagnosis of viral diseases. The bright field or light microscopy, the dark image is formed against a brighter background. We use source of light as a lamp or sunlight. We can focus over the mirror and that can be used for as a source of light. In this light microscopy, we can visualize stained preparation as well as unstained preparation. Among unstained preparation, hanging drop and wet mount preparation can be done to examine the bacterial motility, presence or absence of bacteria, presence of various parasites and their cyst. We can use for that, we can do wet mount preparation. Stained preparation can be examined like Gram's staining, acid fast staining, Albert staining, etc. So this light microscopy gives morphology of bacteria. We can observe staining property of various bacteria and arrangement of various bacteria in light microscopy. These are different types of bacteria which we can observe under light microscope. These are various clusters or cocci. These are cocci in chain. These are tetrads, octate, pairs, and various bacilli. Their arrangement can be seen. And the stained preparation, like this is a picture of Jaden staining or acid fast staining of tubercle bacilli. This also we can observe in light microscope. So unstained preparation as well as stained preparation, both can be observed in light microscope. Now this is a picture of Albert stain. Coronibacterium diphtheriae are shown here, and these are various bacteria which bears flagella. So their motility can be seen under the light microscope. Then next is dark field microscopy or dark ground microscopy. The principle of this is that reflected light is used instead of transmitted light, which we are using in ordinary microscope. So here what we are using, reflected light, and organism appear bright against a dark background. The uses of this dark ground microscopy is that leaving unstained cell and thin bacteria like spirochete. Spirochete are very delicate organisms which we can't observe under the light microscope. So for them, we are using dark ground microscopy. And here we are using dark field condenser. This is a picture showing a spirochete under dark ground microscopy. So these are spirochete. They are spiral shaped. They have, since they are very delicate ones, so against a dark background, we can observe them moving. Next is phase contrast microscopy. Here contrast is enhanced so we can observe the unstained living cell. In order to visualize the unstained living cell, contrast is enhanced. The principle is that differences in refractive index between bacterial cell and the surrounding medium makes the cells clearly visible. The principle of phase contrast microscope is that difference in refractive index between various bacterial cell and the surrounding medium makes the cell clearly visible. And the applications of phase contrast microscopy are for microbial motility, for determining shape of living cells, and for detecting bacterial component like endospore and inclusion bodies. This is a picture under phase contrast microscope. These are sporing bacilli. Bacilli containing endospore. So endospore here we can see inside the bacilli. So this is a picture under phase contrast microscope. Next is fluorescence microscopy. Fluorescence properties, here fluorescence property is used to generate an image. And this uses, the principle is that this uses light of a high intensity source which excites a fluorescent agent, which is dye, which we are using for staining purpose. This in turn emits a low energy light of longer wavelength, which produces the image. This can be of two types, fluorochroming or immunofluorescence. In fluorochroming, directly we are staining the microorganism with the fluorescent dye. And in immunofluorescence, we are using antibody against the microorganism and we label that antibody with the fluorescent dye. So this fluorescence microscopy is of two types, fluorochroming and immunofluorescence. Applications are for diagnosing various diseases, maybe viral diseases, maybe bacterial diseases, maybe parasitic diseases like QBC. In QBC of malaria also we are using fluorescence microscopy. For diagnosis of spirochete we are doing immunofluorescence. Then for diagnosing various viral diseases also like rabies we are doing fluorescence microscopy. Then there is a confocal microscope, which is nothing but advanced fluorescent microscope, which uses optical sectioning in order to get the better resolution. And this is a picture shown here under Mycobacterium tuberculosis under fluorescence microscopy. These are apple green fluorescence is of MTB organism. Electron microscope, here a beam of electrons is used instead of beam of light, which we are using in optical microscope. In optical microscope, what we are using as a source of light, either bulb or sunlight we are using. And here beam of light is used, but in case of electron microscope, beam of electrons is used. Staining is done with heavy metals like lead citrate or uranyl acetate in order to increase the contrast. Negative staining is done with phosphotungstic acid and uranyl acetate. And this is done to study the structure of viruses and bacterial gas vacuoles. And this electron microscopy is done to study the morphology of various viruses, morphology of bacterial flagella, and plasmids and to visualize internal details of various cells. So basically for diagnostic purpose, we are using electron microscope for diagnosis of various viral diseases or in order to visualize the viruses. Electron microscope can be of two types, TEM that is transmission electron microscope and SEM that is scanning electron microscope. This is a picture showing bacteria under electron microscope. This is the flagellum of bacterium and these are details of bacterial cell. So inside structure of cell we can visualize under electron microscope. Thank you very much.